I'm Matthew Murray, an agronomist with Kenya Seed Company. SMART, as my colleague has talked about, is a fungal disease. And science has shown that it can stay in the soil for from four to 10 years. So as long as the conditions are not conducive for it to grow, then you will not be able to see SMART in your field. But when certain conditions are favorable for SMART, like the intermittent rains we have talked about, then you will find that in certain seasons you get SMART in your fields. And from the visit we have seen, even the varieties, it can affect all kinds of varieties. You can see from even varieties which are not necessarily from Kenya seed, we have seen here that they were also affected by SMART. So it's a disease, a fungal disease, which can affect all varieties depending on the certain conditions which are available during the particular time you are planting. And we encourage the farmers that once you find such kind of things, we also encourage them not to feed the SMART with the stovers with the livestock, because what happens is that the livestock again will start spreading the SMART. So the place continuously becomes an hotspot for the SMART disease. And then of course you need to destroy the culls before they rupture, because there are millions and millions of spores in one plant. So you can imagine millions and millions of them will germinate come next season. So there are certain practices in terms of crop rotation. You need to do crop rotation so that you can make sure that you minimize the impact of the SMART. You need to do proper deep plowing. You need to plow so that you bury the spores. Once you bury the spores, then they don't have a chance to germinate. And when the condition now is favorable for the good rainfall, then you can be able to achieve good germination, and therefore you will not be able to see the effect of the SMART.
Like there was some kind of rain, and then there was drought, and then rain again. And that is why they decided to. It's likely that wind is the main cause of the problem. As we have said, kefis does quite a number of issues before seed is sold. We are very sure that seed was bought from Kenya Seed. That's what we have seen. But we still need the farmer to give us the receipt so that we can make a follow-up. In terms of quality, we inspect seed. And during inspection, we give zero tolerance for head SMART or any other SMART. We also test for MLN for purposes of allowing the seed to be sold to the farming community. And we did the same to this lot, if that is what with the correct information we are getting. Is we need to get the lot, we need to scratch it, send it to the number that is on the label, and you will get to information if it is certified seed or not. So we shall actually make a follow-up with the MD Kenya Seed. A lot of seed is 40,000 kilograms. He has told us he bought around 1,600 and something kilograms. So there is a whole 38,000 kilos of the same lot that was sold to other maybe counties. It could be in Bungoma, it could be in Uasin Gishu, it could be any other county. So we are going to make a follow-up. You see, a lot is put together and it's 40,000 kilograms. So if the source is seed, then we need to follow up in other counties, yeah? Because if it has the same problem in other counties, then we can conclude very easily that it was seed. Kefis does not stop at that. We also do what we call post-control of seed in Kitale and Nakuru. So post-control plots have been planted with the same lot. If it has a problem, it will be reflected at post-control. That's when we shall make a follow-up and see.
Within the South Rift, Narok, Bomet, we have so many of them. Agents, we have a branch in Narok, we have a branch in Bomet, where farmers can buy the seeds from. At the same time, in the package, there's something you can scratch and it will be confirmed that the seed is good. We also work with all agencies, the county government of Narok, the county government of Bomet, and all the others who are present here today to fight off any incidences of faking. So we are assuring everybody that Kenya Seed is committed to supplying farmers with top quality seed, and we encourage you to buy our seeds. Our officers are always on surveillance, they are on the ground. That's why we are here today, because of the complaint that was received, and we've already explained that this is just issues to do with environment, rain issues, so it has nothing to do with seed. And when we went around there, we were also able to see, and you're able to see for yourselves, that even competitor material is being affected by the same disease. So we hope and look forward that we'll have enough rains going forward so that our farmers can have our bumper harvest and we ensure food security for our country. We have several agroecological zones. We have the island areas of Mau, so that is where the 6213, 614, 628 is favorable. When you come to around Manarok town, that is mid altitude, so we'd go for the 520, 513. We have the lowlands of Loita, where you could plant things like DH02 or DH04. So it's different varieties. Even when it started in 2011, 2012, it wasn't affecting North Rift, which, as we all know, is the breadbasket of the country. So as far as food security is concerned, we are okay. All our seeds are screened for all these diseases. So by the time it gets out of our factories to the market, it is disease-free. So these are issues that are beyond our control. Nevertheless, I mentioned the fact that a lot is 40,000 kilos of seed. So this farmer bought something slightly lower than 2,000 kilos. So these are all 38,000 kilos, which went to different areas of the country. And it's equivalent to planting up to 3,800 acres. We've not had any complaint from the other areas. We've just heard from here. So our assumption, which we'll still, is that the smut has not affected some other areas.
Ya, tiramos.